Well, it has to, right?
So, it like, if I accept your framework, you can't use this to exclude any of my arguments.
Well, if your arguments don't link to my framework...
If my arguments link to human flourishing...
Well, there's conditions on that. What do you
Why?
Mean? Like, okay, so...
Can your epistemic framework exclude arguments that link to human flourishing?
To my standard of human flourishing, no.
Okay, that's all I wanted to know.
Okay.
All right, thanks.
Awesome.
So,
do you have to link capitalism stuff to link to your framework?
What do you mean?
Do you have to link?
You mean do you have to link capitalism?
No, do you have to link the Ironman stuff to link into the framework?
What do you mean? In terms of like do you have to link into the Ironman stuff to link into my framework?
That's one question, sure.
Well, Ironman like provides a way. It says that
I'm just saying, do you have to win that to link into your framework? Do you have to link win links to capitalism?
I have to win a link to a historical condition that's an ideology that influences juveniles or adults. The specific one I use is capitalism, how it influences the creation of the juvenile work.
Alright.
Yeah.
And in the back?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Before we start, it's an order.
Yeah, absolutely.
Awesome.
Will be off.
One is a very short theory shell, and one is a kind of long counterpart. Everyone ready? Audits by the officer able to generate expressive duty or obligation to identify specifically the non-personal subject followed by passing the statement expressive obligation part of the issue is not specified in the clause but contextually implied from the right definition from the best English dictionary in the English language and specifically praise audits using personally the resolution is applied accurately to USFG because that's the one who controls criminal justice in the United States. The solution to the question with the U.S. government is obligated to do in the Constitution is a constraint on any action the U.S. may take. Any action taken by the U.S. government that violates the Constitution violates its obligations. Juveniles are not, the Supreme Court has reified that proper due process proceedings require all defendants to demonstrate mental competence to stand trial or so at all. Dusty to U.S. 1916, 1993 established that criminal proceeding must meet the constitutional requirements for due process only the defendant's competent to stand trial, which includes capacity to assist counsel and knowing the nature of the proceedings sufficiently to participate and make decisions about the rights of adult defendants and quoted juveniles are not mentally competent to stand trial. Deech. Adults, if they're not capable of functioning in the same way as adults in any manner, little in stressful environments such as trial, one third of children will be classified as incompetent to stand trial, classification of intellectual, emotional, and maturity, including young children, thrive, participating in their own trial. For example, children may withhold important information because they don't trust their attorney, they don't have enough capacity to successfully satisfy their really happy, elected, full victim treaty, prosecuting attorney's cross-examination, 55% of juveniles demonstrated no adequate comprehension of the fourth amendment Miranda warnings. For example, adolescents commonly misinterpret the right to remain silent, and they remain silent until they are told to speak, off one. A, interpretation of all impacts of the Constitution must come from extensions out of the AC, including extension out of the 1AR returns to the NC. B, violation, there's no violation, yet the violation will occur for reason. New impacts, C, standard, minimizing judge intervention. When the debate starts over with new impacts in 1AR, the judge is forced to intervene in firm against two speeches to argue about their impacts, not only get one speech, if there's no 3AR, the judge has to do it. Actually, what my argument could have been, make a decision based on the arguments that work. A, the self-care from the base taken out of the hands of the debaters and their arguments and left to do the whims of the judge. D, is the implication that fairness is reason to reject any new impacts that tries to make the NC standard because the debate means to be honest, both the better debater will by framing unfairly, therefore reject any new implications to the Constitution. Off two. A proper conception of good human flourishing must include all aspects of human beings from humans to not merely acknowledge our rationality, but also acknowledge that we are animals characteristically good humans when we preserve oneself and one species. However, an animal has special physical traits for humans because it gives reasons for action. This matter of the kind person one is in respect to their will, and the animal is a terrible person, so be a good human. She acts right with the right reasons. She must exercise virtue to be good herself. To possess virtue is to be not only well disposed with respect to actions and the reasons, but also to respect to emotions and desires. The concept of virtue emerges as a tailor-made to encapsulate a favorable evaluation of just this aspect to which any ethical relevant wants to be a good human being to be well endowed with respect to the aspects listed in human virtues, make them possess a very good quality human being, who are one who is ordinarily fitted well-fitted as a human being should be, not just in real physical respects to flourish in a characteristically human way. This is going to interact very well with Daniel's framework because he's specifically talking about how we need to allow humans to flourish. The way the government allows humans to flourish is by fostering virtue. So, A is the counterpoint text, USFG will pass the Juvenile Justice Delinquency Prevention Reauthorization Act of 2009 or Senate 678, the section 1 states that the Juvenile Justice Program is to increase services and rehabilitation available. B is the competition to usually smooth the home bills clearing the juvenile system will return to its original purpose of complete rehabilitation is directly boosted to the criminal justice system, which is punitive to. The bill only provides funding for rehabilitation in the juvenile system. Adults cannot be treated in the same system as the bill. C is the solvency. The bill will revert the juvenile justice system back to its total rehabilitation, improving facilities, and increasing services. The CFYJ writes, Senate 678 case focuses on prevention and intervention. Senate 678 does not introduce punitive approaches to delinquency prevention. The Act preserves the prevention of the JJDPA by guarding against any amendments that will link the JJDPA to provisions that introduce new categories of juvenile crime, enhanced penalties, and benefits for states with enhanced penalties for juveniles. Thus, the juvenile system is continues to be rehabilitated. The rehabilitation definition will provide individuals with the resources they need to become virtuous individuals and gives them the choice to correct their plans. This is always the strongest link to the standard because, one, punishment can only make negative claims saying that what an agent did was wrong and that they should be punished. However, it can offer positive claims which agents can internalize and thus not offer any positive impacts of virtue. Rehab teaches individuals how to be good people and integrate into their community. Thus, it offers a positive teaching how the kind of individual one should be. Two, rehab programs specifically designed toward the individual and involve a lot of one-on-one better community contact with them that make them far more likely to instill virtue for that particular individual as opposed to punishment, which punishes very broadly. Now, specifically on the AC. Starting on the epistemology. My NC needs epistemology because it's still grounded in historical context. The Constitution is literally historical context. It's what the government's been obligated to follow for over 200 years. Therefore, I'm still linking into history of the Constitution respects the history of the United States. But this doesn't even matter because I'm not appealing to some sort of moral obligation. I'm just appealing to the government's obligation because audits defined is an act-specific obligation. Now go to his ethical framework where he talks about allowing humans to flourish. He says specifically that a lot of humans, of course, we need to maximize eudaimonia or human fulfillment. However, only virtue ethics that maximizes eudaimonia first has two. By far, the easiest ways of being upright is to be upright. Virtues such as charity, generosity, loyalty, honesty, and justice are to dispositions that make possible mutual cooperation and affection. Without them, all our endeavors would miscarry and joy. I am warned we will unlikely to secure those who do not love their fellow men are less successful than living happily among them. People who set themselves higher moral standards but are within their capacity are generally happier than those who do not set their sights so high. That's another reason for virtue ethics to is oppression thing in terms of fulfilling human flourishing. There's the reason out of the both first test cards, the reasons why you're going to prefer
over, fostering virtue as a means to promoting human flourishing over, his arguments about oppression, his arguments about oppression, don't link it to human flourishing. I'm giving you very clear reasons why fostering virtue and adopting virtue ethics and rehabilitation is what's going to lead you from